General Assembly is only a few days away, and we are so excited to be coming to Cherry Creek Presbyterian Church in Denver, Colorado. We're so grateful for the generous hospitality of the staff and the congregation led by Senior Pastor Brad Strait. Now, this year's assembly will be a time to focus our attention on prayer, praise, people, and preparation for the future that God has for the EPC. I want to talk with you very quickly about two important items: the schedule and your responsibilities as a commissioner. Our schedule begins on Tuesday, June 18th, with our fifth annual Leadership Institute workshops. Our topics range from mentoring young pastors, evangelism, legal issues facing your ministry, how to enhance discipleship in the local church, as well as specialized day-long workshops for global workers, chaplains, youth pastors, and family ministry leaders. On Wednesday morning, our Leadership Institute continues with our plenary speakers. We will be hearing from our very own Andrew Brunson, who will share what the Lord has taught him during his two-year imprisonment in Turkey. On Wednesday afternoon, we'll hear from Doug Webster, who will talk about the power of persistent prayer. Later on Wednesday, we'll begin our business sessions, which will continue through Thursday and finish on Friday afternoon. Our evening activities include the World Outreach Banquet on Tuesday, special worship led by the Cherry Creek Worship Ministry on Wednesday, and our Global Worker Commissioning Service on Thursday. Now, as a commissioner, there are a few things you can do to prepare for the week. First, we encourage you to print out a copy of the Commissioner's Handbook. It'll be available in PDF format from our website. To streamline the process for everyone, our handbook remains at about 80 pages, and it includes all the action items that commissioners will be asked to vote on, as well as several key reports that'll help you in your deliberations. All the annual permanent committee reports and informational items will also be posted on the website and in the GA mobile app. The main section of the handbook includes all the recommendations that'll be decided at this year's assembly. For your convenience, these recommendations are marked for identification as GA 3901 through 3930. Under every recommendation, we include the rationale for the action, as well as any supporting details or comments that will assist in your deliberations. Reviewing these materials before you get to Denver will help you to make the most informed decision. You may be wondering how these recommendations come to the General Assembly. There are four primary sources: presbytery overtures, permanent committees, interim committees and commissions, and local churches and other denominations. All of these recommendations are referred through the office of the Stated Clerk and go either to a standing committee or directly to the floor of General Assembly. A standing committee is a temporary committee that meets or has standing only during General Assembly. Every commissioner is assigned to a standing committee, and each standing committee is resourced by General Assembly permanent committee members and GA staff. The recommendations coming from standing committees are then sent to the floor to be voted on by the assembly. I hope this introduction has been helpful to you. If you have any questions at all, please don't hesitate to contact me. God bless you as you prepare for this year's General Assembly, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in Denver.